makeup. Why don't you put on a little makeup? Hey, this is Anthony Rizzo. This is the Beat My Meat podcast. How you doing? Ow! Time to get your fucking drink on. It's Saturday night. My wife is still in the hospital. She's doing quite well. Her surgery was successful. She'll be home tomorrow. Tomorrow's Sunday. I'll probably have this aired out Monday morning. Is probably I still have to edit it and chop it up. Anyway, how you doing? How's your fucking weekend? What's going on, people? This whole fucking week was kind of shoddy. Tried to get on podcasts when I could. Uploaded to YouTube, Spotify, all my regular social media platforms. We're on Spotify, iTunes, Amazon Music, iHeartRadio, and Google Podcasters. I'm also on TikTok, Facebook, Instagram. All right, we got 60 minutes here for you. We got tunes. We got pranks. We got fucking everything. I'm going to talk about women. I'm going to talk politics. I'm going to just talk, right? You're just going to sit there and listen, and I'm just going to fucking talk. So, how was everybody's weekend? Mine was so-so. I had the kids to myself. I tried to visit my wife as much as I could. I was pulling my fucking hair out. I was up for about 3 days straight, and then I slept constantly. I tried to be up for the kids as much as I could, but I just couldn't stay up the whole fucking time. Anyway, first question of the day. I had in an email, do body count matter? Like how many people you fuck? Fuck yeah, it does. You do not buy a car with 300,000 miles on it. So yes, body count fucking matters. Without a doubt. I wouldn't be with a girl who, say, had like 60 guys or 40 guys. I've seen all over the internet they're talking about, oh, two guys a year? Fuck, that's a lot. That is a lot of fucking dicks. A lot of these women today think that they can sleep around and then find a high-value man. They're out of their fucking gourds, some of these chicks. That's why men and women are staying single. They don't want any fucking drama. We got a lot of tunes. We're going to have music at the 15. We're going to have pranks at the 30. We're going to have more music at the 45. And we're going to rock out with our cock out. So let's see how my weekend was okay. I didn't really do a whole lot. I played some games. I like to get on my gaming system if I have to be home the whole weekend. I mostly like to play some Diablo. I like Diablo 2 Resurrected. I also jump on some Call of Duty. I do like some God of War. I do like some old school games. My wife loves playing the GameCube. She is a Mario Kart junkie. We have a GameCube that has like thousands and thousands of emulated games on it. So she's a fucking junkie when it comes to games on that thing. Me, I don't really like that fucking thing. I prefer the PlayStation or my Xbox. Me and my kids play together, so I kick some ass. They're always trying to fucking cheat. So we actually got our website starting up next week. I got hats. I got shoes. That's right. You heard that fucking right. Shoes. I'm designing shoes. I got shirts, hoodies, sweatshirts. I got tumblers. I'm going to have so much stuff. I'm going to put it out there as soon as it's up. And we got shirts for truckers. We got shirts for patriotic. We got eagles. We got flags. We got everything you can think of. We got some awesome tractor trailer shirts. We got some cool eagle shirts. We got supporter vets. We got a little bit of everything. We got some colorful ones. We got guys. We got girls. We got dad shirts. We got mom shirts. We got it all. It's going to be fucking great. I cannot wait for this to launch. I'm so excited. I am fucking through the ceiling excited. I can't wait for this to drop. I mean, it isn't even about the money. Honestly, in the beginning, I don't make jack shit. What this is about is just getting my shit out there, have people wearing it, and you know what? It's for a good cause. We're donating a portion of the money that comes in, a portion of the profit, we're donating veteran charities and assorted different charities. And you could also write to us too about what charity you want to donate to. Or if you don't want to buy any clothes and you just want to make a donation to veterans, that's fine too. 100% of everything that we say is going to be donated will be fucking donated. And we can't wait to start, honestly. My wife's grandfather and my grandfather all served in the military. Her cousins, her brothers, her uncles, her cousins, everybody. And I had some people on my side as well served. So we're really stoked about that. We want to hold some events for veterans. We want to go, my family and her family know people up at the VFWs. We want to go up there, hold some events, some food, maybe a little bit of music. We might record a live broadcast up there. Fuck yeah! All right. Let me hear that again. Smack that ass. So body count 100% fucking matters. I do not want to be into anybody's glory hole. You know, when a guy meets a woman, he wants to teach her the dirty things. He wants her to be his dirty bitch. He doesn't want some fucking bitch that's slept with 200 guys before him. So there's that. For instance, that's why I'd never date a stripper. I used to work in a strip club, but I'd never date a stripper because I couldn't deal with the fact that they're jumping all over guys. And I know what happens in some of them VIP rooms. They're sucking dick. Fuck that. Fuck that, I say. I am not going to be with no bitch that's been sucking dick all night, and then she wants to come home and kiss me? Fuck that. I don't think so. You are not slobbering on this becker after you've slobbed on five of them. Nah, I don't play that game. It's not going to happen. Usually those girls are fucking dirty. I used to work in a strip club. I have horror stories. The fucking girls that would try to stab the other girls. Insane. I've had it on some other podcasts. I've talked about it. Yes, body count does matter. A good man will always want to be a good man. And if you're in a bad relationship, fucking reach out and get out of it. Because there's nothing worse than being in a terrible bad relationship where you're stuck and you just can't get out of it. It's just horrible. If you're married and you have a boyfriend, a girlfriend, and they're abusing you, get the fuck out. Don't wait another minute. Get the fuck out. And if you got a good woman, don't fucking cheat on her. Do not fucking cheat on her. Help around. Do the fucking dishes. Do some work around the house. I know fucking what working all day is like. Trust me, I've worked 100 hours a week and then came home and had to cook or had a barbecue or take care of my family still. If you got a good woman at home, cherish her. Seriously, cherish her, because that is a good woman many men don't have. A lot of men get out there, get stuck with these fucking bitches. They don't want to fucking do a goddamn thing. They cheat on these guys. I knew a guy one time, his wife was cheating on him in the fucking house, and he's outside sleeping in the car. Fuck that. I would fucking flip shit. That shit would not be going down with me. My wife knows better. If I come home and some guy's in my house, motherfucker's getting shot. I ain't even shitting you. I'm pulling out the gun. I might not kill him. I may just shoot him in the foot, but I am going to fucking maim him. He's going to be fucking limping out of there, okay? So I'd shoot him in the fucking foot. I'd tell him to get on his fucking knees, and then I'd tell him to open his mouth, and I'd stick the fucking pistol in his mouth because that's what he fucking deserved. You don't cheat on another man's wife, okay? Big no-no. I did it once in my life. When I was younger, I was a teenager. I was a younger guy. I was in my teens. I was fucking a woman who was in her 30s, okay? And I felt terrible about it. I felt awful about it. This fucking relationship went on and off for many years. No shit, like 7-8 years. Actually, it was right before I moved down to Tech. We were on and off. I was always kind of dating other girls too. We were always fucking. You know, at the time I was a young kid, I didn't really understand what I was doing. The fucked up part was, it was a friend of mine's mother. I was fucking her mother, and I felt just awful about it. I felt terrible. You know, this woman was married. They had a bunch of kids. They had a house. And meanwhile, sometimes I'm going over there and fucking nailing her on their fucking couch, nailing her on the floor, nailing her all over the place. I mean, how could you not feel bad? She was in a sexless marriage, and sometimes it is what it is. You know, I was young, I was dumb, and I was full of cum. You know, that, unfortunately, that old saying is fucked up, but it's true. So I used to fuck at this older woman. And let me tell you, when you're a young kid, when you're a teenager and you got like 35-year-old pussy, you're like 17, 18. Oh, that's fuck heaven. You know, one that's still fucking tight too. She wasn't a big girl. She was really small. Even though she had a few kids, she was like 5 feet tall. She was about 100 pounds. For a girl who was 100 pounds, she had double D tits. She wore a fucking thong and a G-string. She was sexy. When I say sexy, I mean, my God. And I fucked her every which way I could. Excuse my language, but it was bad. It was dirty. She could really take it, too. She loved it. You know, sometimes that's what happens when you're in a sexless marriage. Make sure you stay current with fuck your girlfriend, fuck your wife. Because it is true. If you're not fucking them, they will find another dick to get jump onto. It's a sad thing. It's a sad world. You don't use it, you lose it. That old saying. Anyway, we're at almost 12-minute mark, 11 and a half. We're going to have music at the 15. We're going to have prank at the 30. More music at the 45. And then we are going to round it out. Yeah, baby. Let me hear it. Let me hear it again, motherfucker. So I want to thank everybody who's been listening in. I got a lot of promotions coming. I got a lot of giveaways coming. I got a lot of stuff coming in the mail. I'm going to give away all kinds of stuff. Hats, shirts, even probably possibly some hoodies. I might even give away some PS4s or PS5s, okay? You got to listen in. You got to follow. You got to like our social media posts, because I may one day just say, you know what? The 20th like's going to get a free hoodie. The 20th like's going to get a PS4, PS5. So you got to keep up to date. We're on social media. We're on Facebook, Instagram. Instagram, YouTube, Spotify, iTunes, Amazon Music, Google Podcasts, and iHeartRadio. Yeah, baby. Yeah, I got a lot of energy tonight. I'm feeling really good, man. To know my wife went to the hospital and she was all good. She's there now and I'm at home. Unfortunately, I had to stay home because of the kids, but I feel really fucking good, you know? I feel really fucking good. We're talking sex. We're talking politics. Fuck politics. You know, some guy said to me today, you know, oh, you must be a Biden fan or you must blah, blah, blah. I said, fuck you. I ain't blue. I ain't red. I'm red, white, and blue, motherfucker. Remember that. I think that we need a new fucking political system or we need somebody or something to fucking stand up and call these motherfuckers out because they are not working for us anymore. That's for goddamn sure. Excuse my language. I don't mean to. I'm going to do a cross. Amen. I'm sorry, Lord. I don't mean to curse and blaspheme with God, but I am fucking so pissed. So fucking pissed and fired up about this government and what is going on in this country. And I just cannot fucking get over it. I just cannot get over it. Sending billions, homeless people, vets that can't fucking eat. We got so many fucking problems. 1 out of 4 children go to bed hungry every night. School system's fucked. National debt's insane. Healthcare's fucked. What the fuck is going on? America needs to fucking step up. Look, I love the fact that people want to help Ukraine. I love it. I hope Ukraine fucking smears Russia all over the fucking wall. I pray a fucking missile goes through fucking Putin's house and blows him up while he's on the fucking toilet, and before it does, fucking diarrhea shoots up into his face. But you know what? First, we need to take care of ourselves before we can take care of everybody else. And that's the thing. So I'm Anthony Rizzo. This is about the 15-minute mark. I got Metallica for you. Okay, so I also got some news for you. Metallica is the first band in the Guinness Book of World Records because they have played on every continent on the planet. That's correct. You heard it right. Every continent on the planet. They achieved this in 2013 when they played in Antarctica. So here we are. We're at the 15-minute mark. Let's kick it.
Teach me a while.
All right, this is Anthony Rizzo, and those were the Metallica boys. I love that song. That song was actually featured in Mission Impossible 2 movie. That was excellent. I like that movie. Fuck yeah, I love that song. Anyway, we got some pranks down at the 30. We're going to have another song at the 45, and then we are going to round it out. This weekend hasn't been too bad, but I will tell you this. I did feel really bad. My wife had to go into surgery on Thursday. I love my wife. I love her to death. You know, I want to stay married the rest of our lives, but I couldn't imagine if something happened to her after a year or two, if I had to go back into the dating scene. I thought about that. I was like, that would really fucking suck. The dating scene is not what it once was. The girls today have all these fucking crazy standards. You got to be 6'5". You got to be tall, dark, and handsome, or you got to fucking have a six pack. I'm more like 5'8", 5'9", with a dad bod. And on top of that, I got a bunch of injuries. I haven't been working out as much as I have been. I was working out a real lot, but once I started getting injured, I kind of stopped working out, so that fucking sucks. You know, I don't earn as much money as I used to. I don't work out now as much as I used to, and I couldn't imagine having four kids and going back on the market, what would that would be like. I just don't know. It'd be a guessing game. It'd be tough. It really would. I guess I would go on like a dating app. And I would say, hey, you know, my name is Anthony and I have four kids, and they'll probably fucking hate your guts. Just expect them to try to trip you down the stairs. You know, I mean, I don't know what this, you know, I'd take her out to dinner. You know, it'd be kind of awkward to be with another woman. You know, I do love my wife. When you're with somebody, you plan on being with them the rest of your life. So it's just kind of a scary thing, a little bit. I mean, everybody's got to think about something like that going into any kind of a big surgery. She's had 3 brain surgeries this year, so it's been absolutely fucking terrible. So I couldn't imagine that if I had to go back in. Honestly, would I go younger? Would I go older? I don't even know. Honestly, I don't know. Would I want more kids? If a woman asked me if I wanted more kids, by that time I'd be like 40 years old or 42. Yeah, I'd probably date younger. I'm not going to go older unless if I did date a bunch of girls younger and they were just too immature and they didn't have their shit together, then I might go close to my age or about my age. I wouldn't purposely go older. I just wouldn't. So we're going to have some pranks at the 30. It's 22 minutes now. We're talking about a dating life that will never exist, hopefully. But honestly, you know, I never thought about it. I never thought about sleeping with another woman, what that would be like, or if she wanted to have kids. If I had to start over having kids at, say, age 40, 42, that would be rough. I wouldn't want to do that. But what's your other option? Spend the rest of your life alone? Have hookers? Some lot lizard? But, yeah, I just don't know. I don't know what, you know, because I've never taken to my wife's sister. She's too skinny and too nerve-wracking for me. She's one of those type of people who's always got anxiety. She's always uptight and anxious and, oh my God. You know, one of those type. It's just really fucking annoying. And she's very, very, very controlling. Just tries to control everything. So it's not like, you know, some people would be like, hey, why don't you fuck the sister? No, it's not really happening. It's just not. And she doesn't have any good looking cousins or anything like that. I mean, I really don't, not a big fan of keeping it in the family, but you know what I mean? Whenever you break up with somebody, or God forbid you're a widow, you start looking around at the closest people first who you're not related to. And that just wouldn't work out for me. My wife doesn't have any real close friends who are good looking that, you know, would be single, I would think, to be involved with. So I don't know. I'd have to come up with something. Probably hit up a dating website, maybe like Match.com, maybe Plenty of Fish, something like that. You know, I would just see where it'd go from there. I don't know, honestly, if they'd want to date a guy who's not making that much money, has a dad bod, and on top of that, you know, has 4 kids. That would be a fucking nightmare, probably, for some. I can't imagine any woman would want to do that. Yeah, I mean, I'm not ever going to have to worry about it, hopefully, so no big deal. I couldn't imagine, you know, what dating even later in life would be like. God forbid if something happened to your, you know, your significant other, and if you were like 75, 80 years old, what dating, or even, let's say, in your 60s, if you were in your 60s and you were thinking about dating, I just don't know what that would be like. You know, like my grandfather passed away, you know, she's lonely now. She doesn't have anybody. She's 77 years old. I don't know what you do. I mean, is it wrong to go out with somebody, even if you were married, even if you knew your other half for, you know, 50 or 60 years? Do you take that plunge? Do you not want to be lonely? She doesn't really have a lot of friends, and there's not much family that visits us. So what do you do? I don't know what you do. I don't know what I would do. And I'm a younger guy. Look, a guy's got to have his needs met. I completely understand. What? Yeah, so I completely understand. No. No, no crow's nest for me. I'm good. I'm more like Yeah, baby. Because, you know, a man still has needs, but honestly, I wouldn't want to dishonor my wife. It's a real double-edged sword, and you don't want your kids resenting you, too. That's really rough. You know, we just have to see where it goes. I'm not really looking forward to anything like that, and it is what it is. The dating scene is completely different today. These girls today are just drunk, stupid, and retarded. I mean, listen, I have a Facebook account, a personal one, and I got a bunch of girls on there, and they're like fucking prostitutes. I mean, that or you go to OnlyFans. I cannot believe how many girls are now on OnlyFans. I never even knew what fucking OnlyFans is. I still don't. I guess girls, they'll show you your butthole for like $5 or $6 or a monthly subscription, $19.99, they'll show you their butthole. I mean, I don't even understand why there's any lot lids anymore if that's the case. You know, why is anybody prostituting? I would just fucking jump on OnlyFans. I wouldn't sell my pussy. Fuck that. Anyway, we're about 3 minutes out. We're going to have the Jerky Boys. I love the Jerky Boys. Got to have them Jerky Boys. I plan to get some new pranks next week. We've been working on them, and we've just kind of been taking a break. We've been trying to figure out new pranks, and we try to keep it fresh, the content, so there'll be some new pranks. We can't wait. I'm Anthony Rizzo, the Beat My Beat podcast, and we love it. We love our subscribers. We thank you for following. I thank you for listening, and I'm ready to kick some ass. I am fired up this Saturday night. I want to get some drinks. Tell me, you should email me what you fucking like to drink. Honestly, I'm a big Jack Daniels fan. I've always been a fan of Jack and Coke or just straight Jack. I don't even need no shooter or nothing like that. I'm good. You know what? I always asked when I was at the bars, I would ask for a couple shots of Jack, and then I'd ask for a Jack and Coke. I was chasing it if I had to with the Jack and Coke, so you're getting more alcohol and a drink. Hell yeah. I used to work in bars and some clubs when I was younger. Let me tell you, you'd be surprised some of the fucked up shit fucking goes on in some of them places, you know? I've walked in on some girls fucking eating each other out. I mean, you'd just be surprised what goes on in the world. I mean, you really would. You go out to the fucking parking lot, and there's fucking, like, people fucking in the parking lot. You'd be surprised how many people I've run into. Even at Walmart. I go to Walmart, and, you know, you see that car out in the fucking parking lot. It's parked away from everybody else. And then, you know, you might pull over there, or it's down the same lane. I go in there. You can clearly see the guy's getting his dick sucked. I mean, all power to you, but fuck, choose a different place. You know what you choose? You choose a hotel room parking lot. You know, a lot of people think that you're staying at the hotel, it's all good. It's just fucking, you know, you got kids, you got this, you got that. It's fucking bad, man. Just go pay a fucking $10 for a hotel room or $30 or whatever the fuck it is and go fuck your brains out somewhere. Because copping blowjobs in the Walmart parking lot, it's not any good. It's not a good thing to do. I mean, I've done it. Listen, I ain't proud of it, but I've done it. You know, I've fucked at most places. I've fucked at the park. I've fucked at a movie theater. I've fucked at a baseball stadium, okay? I was right outside the baseball stadium. I got this VIP parking, and me and my wife had these really tinted windows. We decided to go at it right outside the stadium parking lot. And by the way, this was like 2 days before she ended up giving birth to my son. No shit. She was like totally horned up. We're parked outside. We were living up near Pittsburgh at the time, and they had this VIP parking, and all of a sudden she starts giving me this look. We're about to get out. I just parked the car. I got like 3% tint on it, and she gives me this look, and I'm like, what's that look? And she's like, you wanna fool around before we go? And I'm like, fuck yeah. There's a bird shit in the woods? Fuck yeah. How about a bear? There's a bear shit in the fucking woods? Yeah, I want to get my dick sucked before going in there. So she ends up fucking blowing me, and then I end up bending her over the fucking middle console. Yeah, baby. That's how you play ball. First you start with the bat, then you go to the balls. Anyway, I'm Anthony Rizzo. This is the Beat My Meat podcast. Here are the Jerky Boys. Fuck yeah, play it.
Who's this? This is Jake. Calling about the job, driving, I saw it in the paper.
Yes.
Yeah, well, you still need a driver or what?
Did you fill an application with us, Jake?
Pardon me?
Huh?
Speak up there, what did you say?
You fill an application with us?
No. I saw the ad in the paper and I'm calling you, fruitcake. I'm looking for a job driving a truck.
We're looking for movers.
Yeah, well, that's what I do.
What class driver's license do you have?
I got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, I got them all.
Yeah, class 1?
Yeah, I drive buses, trucks. I'll back a truck through the fucking two-family house garage. One of those big two-ton trucks.
When was the last time you drove a truck or trailer?
Oh, jeez, what the fuck? I'd say about 2 weeks ago, I robbed one down in Jersey, and I drove it up here to New York. Fucking flying. Drove it through the tolls, no stopping, no nothing. I'm good.
I see. Why don't you call back on Monday?
Hey, I'll tell you what. I come in, I'll take you for a test spin. How's that? We go out and we take the truck around the fucking block. I speed, I pop wheelies, I'm good, baby.
Call back on Monday, Lantana.
All right, can I get you? I want you. You sound good. You and me, we make a team. You drive with me. All right?
What's your name again?
Jake.
Jake, who did you work for, Jake?
Oh, geez, I worked for Moish. I worked for Mayflower. You know? Oh, yeah. Don't, hey, I was good with them, too.
You worked with Moishes?
Yeah, that's right.
When?
About, what, 2 years ago? See, what I got problem there, they get fucking scared when I pop the wheelies and all that shit. You know, I pop a lot of wheelies. I'm good with that shit. You know, I don't break no merchandise either. I get it there 2 hours ahead of time, all the time. What do you say?
Say, if you pop any wheelies there, I'm not even gonna put in your
position. Listen to me. I don't break nothing, Sizzle Chest. I'm good.
Okay, call Monday. We'll set up an interview. Okay?
All right, I'll do that there, Rubberneck. I'll call you Monday.
Okay.
All right, Fruitcake. See you later.
Hello, may I help you?
Yes. Hello?
Hello?
Are you dental malpractice?
Yes. Where did you get our number?
I went to dentist. I went for tooth decay. They did awful thing. He ripped my teeth out my gum. I cannot talk. I cannot eat. He cursed me and hit me while I'm sleeping.
He hit you.
And then he put me under sedation. I wake up, my pants on button. My teeth gum is dripping blood. I cannot even blow bubbles when I chew gum when I drive cab.
What? I don't
believe. You gotta help me. They're cursing me. I went there, I'm crying. They cursed me, threw me out. You got to help me.
Which dentist is this?
This man named Mr. Rocco on Bronx. Mr. Rocco, Louis Rocco.
Louis Rocco?
Easier, yes. I go there for a cab. I stop cab. My tooth hurting. I go in. He say, sit down. Then he punch my teeth. I'm bleeding. And then they my pants on button, and then they curse me.
Okay. Give me a number. Can you give me your number?
Yes. 555-3591.
555-3390.
Yes. It's okay. Then I wake up, my pants on button.
Okay.
But why they do this thing? They don't. What? Why? I'm new in this country, and then this is the treatment by people.
Okay. What is your name?
My name is Ali Kamal.
Can you spell that? Why are you screaming?
To my teeth! The guy took my teeth and punched them! I can't make even a chew popcorn, nothing! You got to help me, Allah! I pray to Allah that somebody help me! Please help me! This man must be stopped!
Did you call another farm?
No, I call you!
Where did you get our number?
From newspaper.
Newspaper.
Okay. Okay, I'm too much pain. Too much pain.
Okay. Bye.
Oh, man. This is Anthony Rizzo, and this is the Be My Meat podcast. Oh, man, that's fucking great. I love it. I love the Jerky Boys. They're originally from New York, and they are just a bunch of fucking clowns, and I love it. They tell some of the funniest stories, and they fuck with people so well. You could tell that last one, that fucking lady knew that he was fucking with her. She was starting to laugh at some of the stuff he said, but it was funny nonetheless. Anyway, we're going to start talking some more shit. Some of the best places I've gotten laid were some places you shouldn't. Always the naughty places are always the best places, right? The golden fruit that you're not supposed to touch. But I've had sex at school one time. I took this one girl in the back hallway. You know, there's always like a back staircase that nobody uses. And she ended up giving me a blowjob in between. What happened is you go down the stairs, you got the middle platform, and then you go down another flight, and then you'd go out the doors. So you would know there were two sets of doors, too, they had to go through before they can get to the hallway. So you'd hear if somebody was coming. But yeah, I was on the back hallway one time, and this girl was giving me a blowjob, and she blew me right then and there. And it was fucking great. Told my friends about it. That lunch was excellent. But anyway, one of my favorite places always to get a blowjob, because I always like getting my dick sucked more than sex. I like sex, but I always loved getting my dick sucked really good, especially if the girl knew what she was doing. Going to movie theaters. I always loved going to movie theaters and getting a blowjob. Especially, I can't tell you how many times on my birthday I'd go into a movie theater and I would pick like the worst fucking movie to pick. I'd be like, oh yeah, how long's that movie been out? That movie's been out 2 weeks. No, not that one. Oh, that movie's been out 8 weeks? And what is it called? Sex in the City? And I would always pick the worst fucking movie, and it would always be dog shit. I'd go in there, there'd be nobody in there. I'd sit in the back row, so in case anybody did walk in, I could see them before they would see me. Because nobody walks in and then tries to see the back row. They walk in, they're trying to find a spot. They might peer in the back, you know, while they're finding their spot, but I would have more than enough time to get my drawers up. So what I used to do is I would go into the back row, start kissing on whoever I was with, I never did it with my wife. I always did it with a girlfriend, some girl I was. But yeah, I would fucking, you know, start fucking kissing her, you know, that sort of thing. You know, run your hand up her skirt or whatever she was wearing. Eventually, pull down my pants and she'd blow me right in the movie theater. Let's just say, you know, I always dated with girls that always cleaned up the mess, so there was never any worry there. Yeah, I always really liked having sex. For instance, in cars. Cars are always a great place to fuck a girl, in like the back seat, or even if you're in the front seat driving and you get a blowjob. I always loved getting blowjobs while I drove. It was always just fun. I always had really tinted windows on whatever car I had. I had a Chrysler 300. I had a Mustang. I'd always have like 3%, 4% tints. So my tints would always be dark enough where nobody could see in my car, and a girl could just lean over and slob on my knob anytime. So that was always the best place. I always liked the park too. The park was always a good place. You know, you get a little picnic going, maybe a little lunch, you bring a blanket. It's not too hot out. It's like maybe 70, 75 degrees. Although one time I did get caught. No shit. I had my girlfriend bent the hell over, and I was plowing her from behind. This was like 22 years ago, something like that. And I'm plowing her from behind, and all of a sudden, I kid you not, there's a fucking field trip that walks through, like, I want to say maybe like 100 yards away. We are scrambling for our clothes and running into the park forest, okay? Butt ass naked. She's running. I'm running. It was like, fuck. So I ended up just running in there, and we ended up just continuing in there. They seen us. We saw a bunch of adults looking at us. We didn't give a fuck. We got in deep enough. I said, bend the fuck over. We're finishing this shit. We ended up finishing it, and the rest is history. But yeah, always loved banging girls in like weird places, cars, like I said, the school, parking lots. I've banged a lot of girls at friends' houses, like his couch. I've always loved going to girls' houses and banging them in their parents' bedroom. That's always a favorite. The shower's always a really good place. Always love the shower. But you got to have one of them, like, walk-in showers. You can't have one of them, like, showers that's just like a bathtub. It's just not big enough. It really isn't. To be dogging some bitch in the bathtub, it's just not good. I mean, listen, I love the hot tub. I can't tell you how many hotel hot tubs I was fucking girls at, or even in the pools. It'd be like 10, 11 o'clock at night, and I'd banging some girl out in the pool or a hot tub. I did that in New Orleans. I went to New Orleans. They have a Marriott over there in the French quarters. Me and this girl I was seeing at the time, we were watching a porno, and we were kind of fucking. She was blowing me, and we were having sex. Like, a couple hours later, like 2 hours later, we decided to, you know, fuck again. I said, hey, I said, they got a hot tub right around the corner. It's now like 10 o'clock at night. I said, let's just go fucking it. So I end up, you know, getting undressed. She gets undressed. We get in the hot tub. I'm fucking her. And no shit, the janitor fucking walks in while I'm fucking her. The dude looked like he was a deer in the headlights. He was like, oh, sorry. You know, this dude, I'm afraid he's going to fucking tell on me. So I'm fucking sitting here plowing her, trying to finish, because I want to get the fuck out of there before they call the police or God knows what. They come up with the front desk and tell us we need to leave. I figured I get out of there quick enough, I can get back to my room. They'll never know who it exactly was. They didn't have no cameras in there. They might have had them in the hallway, but they didn't have them in there. So I'm fucking her really. Now I'm like, uh-oh. She's looking at me. She's like, aren't you going to stop? I'm like, nope. It's plow time. It's like fucking December in New York, and I'm plowing. So I ended up going twice as fucking hard, you know, because I already fucked her 2 hours ago. So it is now 2 hours later. I'm really bad at coming a second time. Like, if I'm fucking a girl twice, that's why I usually don't go for seconds, because I could last hours. No kidding. I ain't even shitting with you. There was one time I lasted 6 hours. I'm not even fucking kidding with you. I fucked a girl for 6 hours and I couldn't come a second time. It was a girlfriend of mine. It was actually the older woman. We were doing everything you could fucking imagine. I fucked her on the couch. I fucked her in a bed. I fucked her on the floor. She had rug burn all over her knees and her arms and her back. I fucked the shit out of her. And finally, she was like, it's fucking like 3 o'clock. It's time to go. I was like, fuck, all right, I gotta go. I didn't even want to fuck her anymore. That's how fucking tired I was. I'm just full of sweat. She's full of sweat and I'm sweating on her. It's one of them type of sexes where it's really fucking, I mean, we did every position. We tried more oral. We did everything. I just could not get off. And that's how I usually am. Even with my wife, if I try to fuck, you know, she knows to not really bother me for a second term, you know, because I can't get off the second time. I just can't. It's very, very, very hard. Very hard. I mean, there have been instances where I did, but it will take me sometimes like an hour to 2 hours to get off. I don't know how some guys can go a second time and they're like, oh yeah, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. No, it's like 2 hours for me. No shit. That's why I don't even bother. I'm like, eh. We'll get everything we need done in the first go. But usually I do. I'm not one of them three-minute men, you know. We like a lot of oral sex, me and my wife. So, you know, it's a good sex life. We're at the 45. I'm going to play a song in just a minute. So we usually have a very strong sex life, you know. So we had sex right before she had her surgery. But sex for us usually lasts like 45 minutes to an hour. But that's like the whole thing. You know, we jump out the shower. We start kissing, playing with the tits, playing with this, playing with that. You know, we start touching each other. You know, we might go down on each other, whatever. And then, you know, finally when we get to the sex part, usually like 15-20 minutes. It just depends on the position, but that was one of the greatest things about me and her relationship. We never worried about each other cheating on the other because we've always had such a strong connection physically and emotionally and mentally. We have such a strong sexual connection too. You wouldn't feel it with anybody else. It's not the same. I've had girlfriends. She's had boyfriends before we met each other. It's just not the same. I'm lucky. She's lucky. We're lucky together. I couldn't imagine having to fuck somebody else. I wouldn't. And would I enjoy having sex? It's hard to say. I really couldn't tell you. But, I mean, at the end of the day, a man does still have needs besides his fucking hand. You know, it's rough. Honestly, would I want to be with somebody else? No. Would I have to be with somebody else? Possibly. I mean, you don't have to. Like I said, a man does have needs. I'm not going to beat my meat for the rest of my life. You know what I'm saying, fellas? Anyways, 46 minutes. I am Anthony Rizzo, and this is the Beat My Meat podcast, baby. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Here's Toxicity.
Time activity, the toxic. adversity, adversity, adversity.
This is Anthony Rizzo, and this is the Beat My Me podcast. Yeah, baby. I love that song, Toxicity. Fucking love System of a Down. That's why I led them off with the intro, because I just fucking love them. You know, I was talking about me and my wife's sex life and a few other sex lives I've had. I gotta say, I've never really been that fucking kinky, though, man. I can never, for instance, we're not about sharing, me and my wife. I've been trying to get her into a threesome. If you heard that other episode, I think I might have gotten her. Because she seems to be interested and she's been poking around about it. I will fill you in on how that goes. Anyway, I've never really been that crazy, that kinky. For instance, I could never be a swinger. I could never fucking sit there and watch somebody else fuck my wife. I just couldn't do it. I don't know how people do it. I couldn't do it. I would probably lose my shit, you know, seeing her suck another dick. I couldn't live with that. I couldn't be married to her. We couldn't have a home. We couldn't live together. It just wouldn't work out if she was blowing some other guy. I'm too jealous. I think most guys are jealous, but, you know, I'm just way too jealous to let that shit go. You know, I've never really been into too much kinky shit. My wife is into some kinky shit, though. She likes, like, that dominatrix shit. She wants to be dominated and put the fucking, like, rubber ball in her mouth and fucking gag her type shit. She loves gagging. They don't call it Beat My Meat for a reason. Anyway, she loves anal sex, too. She's totally down for anal sex. She can take it. She takes it like a champ. And funny thing is she'll bait me on it. She'll be like, come on, what are you, chicken? You gonna fuck me in the ass tonight? I'm like, damn, girl, what the fuck? But yeah, I ain't chicken. Fuck that. You want to get dogged in the ass? Fine. Bring it on. Them girls that can take it, the ones that like it, oh yeah, they really like it. You get a girl who likes anal sex, man, they will want you to fuck them in the ass all the time. I mean, it's a good thing. It's not bad. Just make sure they take a shit and clean their ass right. Otherwise, you'll come up with a fucking brown dick. Anyway, I'm not into any of that dominatrix shit. My wife, if for some reason, my wife is from Texas, and I fucked a lot of girls in Texas, even though I'm not from Texas. They love to be, like, fucking choked and, like, spanked really hard. Like, they like to get, like, abused. When I say abused, like, they want to be, like, fucking choked, man. You see, I came from New York. They don't choke bitches in New York. They love their fucking foreplay, and they love playing around. They might... you know, they might have a sex swing or something like that, but they don't go through no fucking choking and all this. Maybe it's a new thing today, but it seems like a lot of girls are fucking bisexual these days. That was why I brought it up with my wife in that other episode. She fucking loves other girls. When I say loves, I mean she fucking looks at more ass than a proctologist, okay? I'll put it to you that way. She is constant. I mean, and she just doesn't like girls. She likes ass. She loves staring at other girls' asses. Well, it's fucking, that's why I tried talking her into it. Let's find a girl with a really nice fucking ass. Yeah, let's play. Am I wrong for that? I mean, come on. Am I that bad? I don't think it'll create jealousy. You know, honestly, I think my wife will get into it. We almost got into a poly relationship one time. This girl I knew, her name was Kayla, and we almost got into a poly relationship. My wife kind of backed out of it last minute. There were some other things going on. For instance, this girl Kayla was like in love with me, so she kind of seen it as like a threat. Whereas if we picked this girl who's kind of neutral, where she's kind of like there for the both of us, it'd be a little different, I think. For some reason, I've been just talking a lot of sex lately. If I had to have sex with another woman again, I said, man, let me share this on my podcast. It's pretty fucked up. We're at the 54-minute mark. We got about 5 more minutes. Girls today, honestly, the way the dating scene is, I don't want any part of it. There's no dating anymore. It's more like just a fuck buddy or sugar mama or sugar daddy. That's why everybody's staying single. They're like, fuck that shit. You know, I'm not going to be anybody's sugar daddy. I ain't got the money to be anybody's sugar daddy. And honestly, I mean, if I could find a sugar mama, fuck yeah. I got a friend, he's on the next street, and his wife makes like $150,000-$170,000 a year, and he don't even work. She bought his truck. She pays for the house. I'm like, fuck, man. The kids are not little anymore. They go to school. I'm like, fuck, how do I get into something like that? I've always dated women who didn't work. My wife was a stay-at-home. Now that I'm older, and if I ever did have to get into the dating scene, I'd want a bitch who's got a job. A good job. Not some bitch working at, you know, Walmart cash register. I want a woman who's got a career. Maybe she's in management. Maybe she's a fucking bank manager. You know, I don't really give a fuck what she's in. As long as she brings home $75,000 a year, I would be fucking thrilled. I will fucking stay home and eat that pussy as much as you want. I will eat the booty like grocery, okay? Because that's what I would fucking love, you know? I can't work no more. I have a fracture in my spinal cord. It hurts me every fucking day. Every day. They consider that a broken back, and it's not going to get better. It's actually going to get worse. I'm trying to look into other doctors. I seen a doctor for it. He said, basically, I can't help you. That's what he told me. I was like, really? So I talked to doctors I know. They said, yeah, you can get help for it. So see somebody else, see a different fucking doctor, and get it taken care of. I said, all right, well, it would be nice if I could stay home, if I ever had to remarry, get a sugar mama, relax, maybe game all day, do my podcast, upload to my social media and my store. Like I said, you need to check out. You need to check out the store. Next week, it drops shirts, hats, hoodies, all different designs. You would be blown the fuck away. We are blowing our competitors' prices out of the fucking water. We are blowing everybody's prices out. Everybody. Anybody who has an actual brand, Grunt Style, Champion, all these other fucking, you know, Under Armour, all these brands, Nike, we are fucking undercutting all of them, and we are producing high quality items for our consumers, for our listeners, but for anybody else as well. They're for veterans, they're for truck drivers, they're for the working class. We've designed them to be as cheap as we can. We're literally barely even making any profit. You see, when you make good profit on clothing or fashion, you're supposed to be at around 20%. We're at like 10%, and we're going to take 5% of that and donate it to charities. So we're going to be making only like 5% of each item. We're creating cheap brands, high quality brands. We can get out there. People will buy it. People will want it. Great designs, great writing on it, great font. You're going to fucking, when I say you're going to love it, you're going to fucking love it. You are going to drop out of your fucking chair when you see how many shirts are just $15 and how high quality and the designs are fucking great compared to how many other places on Amazon and everywhere else. You're going to drop fucking out of your chair. And by the way, we are going to be on Amazon probably by the end of the month. Cannot fucking wait. Look for it. It's going to be the Beat My Meat podcast, Beat My Meat Entertainment, and it is going to be fucking great. I'm going to drop the website as soon as it drops, and it will also be connected to any social media platforms that we have. So anyway, we're at the 58-minute mark. I'm going to call it a night, and I hope you have a great fucking weekend. Get your freak on. Remember, don't forget, we're not here for a long time, but we're here for a good time. All right, adios. I'm out. Thank you.
children bright, ripple is burning, and the girls are getting sick, snorting coca in the bathrooms while boyfriends pick up chicks. Darling, I'm lost, I heard you whispering that night in Fountain Square. Trash-filled streets made me wish you were heading home. There was love inside the basement where that woman used to lie. In a sleeping bag we shared upon the floor most every night. And darling, I'm drunk in everything that we love. Turn to stone, so pack your bags and just come back home. And I'm wasted, you can taste it. Don't look at me that way, 'cause I'll be hanging from a rope. I will haunt you like a ghost. If my woman was a fire, she'd burn out before I wake, be replaced by pints of whiskey, cigarettes, outer space. And somebody moves, and everything that we have turns to stone. So pack your bags, come back home. And I wrote this on an airplane where the people looked like ants, and the woman that you loved was gone. She's bombing East Japan. Don't fucking move, 'cause everything that we have will turn to shit. But we've got a lot, don't you dare forget. 'Cause I'm wasted, you can taste it. Don't look at me that way, 'cause I'll be hanging from a rope. I will haunt you like a ghost. Thank you.